Hey, what's up guys? Gian here of GadgetPilipinas.net. We are unboxing a new device from Oplus, and this time it's going to be the Oplus USA Compact Pro. The Oplus Compact Pro is positioned as a photography smartphone or photography-centric smartphone, and according to Oplus, this takes professional DSLR quality-like photos. So now, for those of you who are music buffs, it comes along with it a JBL Pure Bass 300 or T300A headphones. This is the Oplus USA Compact Pro retail box. It looks like the Oplus Presto, which we unboxed a few months ago. All right, cool. Let's open this up here. It has that rubbery feel. So for those of you who are wondering how it feels like, it's not carton, it's rubber. Nice! Okay, oop, what's that is? What is that? All right, let's put that aside for now. What else can we find? If we open the flap once more, we get a micro USB cable. Right, and your standard earphones. Charger. The charger is what is this? It's 5 volts, 2 amperes. Cool. We have the manual, the Compact Pro. We also get the free screen protector and a warranty card, and also a 64 gig. Micro SD card. Nice addition. So basically those are the things that you can find inside the retail box of the Oplus Compact Pro. Now this is the phone right here. Now for those of you who are privy on specifications, the Compact Pro of Oplus has a 1.3 gigahertz octa-core processor. It has 2 gig of RAM. It's a little RAM, actually, to be honest. 16 gig of internal memory, and as you can see right here, it has an included free 64 gig micro SD, and it is 4G LTE, and it has 700 megahertz support for LTE bands. 13 megapixel rear facing camera with BSI and dual LED flash. Now however, that one takes DSLR like quality photos. We'll find it out soon. And it has 5 megapixel front camera, Bluetooth, GPS, AGPS, and it includes a 3045 milliamperes battery. Let's remove this. Now this is the screen. The screen is 5.5 inch, and above it, we have the sensor. We have the 5 megapixel front facing camera and an earpiece. There are no capacitive buttons below. This has an on-screen button. On the right side, we have the volume rockers and the sleep and wake button. Below, we have the micro USB port and a microphone. There is a secondary microphone at the top of the camera right there for noise cancelling purposes. Now above, we have the 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. And there's dual LED flash. This is the 13 megapixel rear facing camera. And we've got here the speaker grills. The design is a little minimalist for me, so I guess if you're a fan of minimalist design, then I guess you'd love this device. But I'm a bit concerned with the RAM, because the RAM configuration is a little small for its price. The device currently sells for 11,395 pesos, close to 12,000. That's about 11,400. And for those of you who are into mid-range devices, almost 11,500 phones would probably get you a, for example, an Asus Zenfone 3 5.5 inch. However, for those of you who are into photography, that as promised by Oplus, this one takes DSLR-like quality photos, then you might want to consider this device. It's a little early for us to say all of this because we haven't even reviewed the device yet, but specs-wise, for me, the price is a little bit of a concern because it's a little pricey in our opinion. There you go, that's the 3045 milliampere battery. I guess for those of you who have any concerns or questions about the device, do let us know in the comment sections below because I know you have a lot of questions and you have some concerns about the device. Of course, this one has a custom proprietary UI that sits on top of the Android 6.0 Marshmallow. So, well, we have been using OPLUS and so far they have the least bloatware among the local devices that we've reviewed. So I guess if you're into less bloatware smartphones rather, you might want to consider getting this as well. Wow, the screen is really good. Now that's the kind of screen that I like. In fact, it's way better than the OPLUS Ultra 3.0 that we unboxed before. I like it. And there you have it. Let me lower the brightness so you guys can see the screen properly. Of course, the UI is a little different. It's not stock Android, so you know that there's a bit of customization involved. The screen is very responsive, in my opinion. While this is positioned as a photography device or photography-centric smartphone, I would have preferred if this one had its own dedicated button for camera. This one doesn't have any, so that's a bit of a letdown, to be honest. Camera. Oh, hi there. Front-facing camera is a little off for me because the saturation is not that good. So much so for a 5-megapixel camera. While the rear-facing camera is a little nice, the problem is it seems that it doesn't have any autofocus at all. Unless we switch. Okay, that's cool. The question is, what is that button for? Let me now switch the camera to full screen. It's pretty responsive. Oh, why is it taking so many photos? Flash? If we compensate the photo with flash, it seems that it's doing its job quite well as well. All right, cool. Now, in terms of camera, since this is a camera-centric device, I would hope that this one has several modes. There is exposure. We can increase the exposure level. Even bring it down to plus one. There's white balance as well. Okay, cool. And there's beauty mode. We don't need that. There are some modes, or probably filter. These are just filters. And it seems that there are no modes available. I really hoped for it to have some modes, like let's say slow shutter mode, pro mode. There is none at the moment, which, you know, for photography buffs like you guys, like most of you guys, this is a little disappointing for me. Nevertheless, the camera looks really good, takes good photos, and we cannot wait to check it out once we review this in greater detail. As you can see right there, it's really good. There's a bit of grain on that side despite very good lighting. We'll pit it against other local and international brands so as for us to be able to see how good it is compared to other brands, as I mentioned. Screen is great, as I mentioned. Performance-wise, it's it's fast enough, although it only has 1.3 gigahertz of processor. There are, of course, some software enhancements and features. There are Google Control, the Doodle Control, rather, which basically is similar to gesture control. At boot, the storage is the available storage a little over than 12 or 11 gig rather, because the only MB use is about 353, as you can see right here. Okay. And for the RAM at boot, since this has 2 gig of available memory, it has 1.1 gig available. If we close the camera, it should be able to update. And well, still, it has 1.1 gig of internal or memory available. That was pretty much everything that we can say about the Compact Pro at the moment. And we hope to be able to review this in 2 to 3 weeks from now and give you our full review later on. Now, since the device also includes a free T300A JBL headset, we might as well open it here on this unboxing video. We have it right here. This is the retail box, and let's now open it. Here we go. Easy does it. All right, we got the first one. Next one. We got it as well. There you have it. Let's open now. There is a carrying case or none? Well, there is. There is a carrying case for the headset. The build is a little cheap for me. The frame isn't that sturdy. The foam at the top is quite good. The quality is quite nice. And hopefully it sounds great as well. The cables are too thin. It's not tangle free. I prefer it to be flat, but the cable isn't flat at all. So I would expect this to really, you know, tangle inside the case or probably inside my pocket. Right, that's pretty much everything that we have at the moment. This is our unboxing of the OPLUS USA Compact Pro. Now, we know that you have some questions about the device, so we would appreciate if you can post them on the comment section of this YouTube channel or on our Facebook page or also on our website. We would appreciate that. And if you haven't subscribed to our YouTube page, we would love as well that you subscribe to it. And if you haven't liked our Facebook page, just go to facebook.com/gadgetpilipinas. So that's about it, guys. Thank you very much for watching this unboxing video.